Hey, what's going on YouTube? It's Nick from NoobKill coming at you with another Madden video today. So guys, our brand new program with, of course, the Madden Trail is in the game. We're about to take our first looks. I just got home from work and all that stuff, so I haven't got to play any Madden Mobile or anything like that. But we did do a sneak peek yesterday. We already knew who the masters were going to be following, just like all rookie, the other non-grandmaster. So you're going to see like Dak Prescott, he is auctionable, but everybody else in the program, beside the 98 overall, are non-auctionable in this one. Now, they did a couple different things and all that stuff, but I really don't know what direction we're going to be heading forward with, of course, with all these non-auctionable players. You guys just saw yesterday, we had Mean Joe Green, 98 overall Grandmaster, become non-auctionable, Grandmaster. So that was a little bit of a weird one. Basically, if you did not complete the set yesterday, you could not be able to go ahead and complete Mean Joe Green, or you cannot get Mean Joe Green no more, right? But that is that. You guys can check out his all the cards right here. Now, huge shout out to my homie Goss. He's one of the content team dev team members, and I believe this is his first program that he has went ahead and made. And you guys know Goss is my homie. I think we've done a video with him before when I was down at EA and all that stuff. But of course, he always makes like the cool cards, the insane cards, 99 stats and all that stuff with the players. Like a couple players inside of a program, they're like stand out. Like, you know, they're souped up. My boy was the one that made that, so I'm really excited about Madden Trail and everything. I'm excited about the players and everything, but let's check what it says. So clear the table and set up the board. It's time to play Madden Trail. So select your game pieces and build your strategy along the Madden Trail. Complete the Madden Trail events daily to collect Madden Trail items, exchange Madden Trail players, and of course items for 98 overall Trail Masters. Now yesterday it did say like 96 plus, so that was like a typo I knew, but of course you do need 92s to 96 overall players. So yeah, we can see Dak Prescott right here. You guys saw the stats yesterday. I don't believe anything changed right here. His short is at 98, so no 99 stat, of course, on the back of the card. If you guys remember the Ronnie Lott from All Rookie, no 99 stat on, of course, the back of the card, but he had a 99 stat, which I believe was his hit power. Something could be 99 for, of course, Dak. I'm not too sure, and everything like that. And of course, DeAndre Hopkins, you guys can see right there, 94 speed, 97 catches, 99 stat is catching traffic. Now, this is the one I'm going to be going for, Miles Jack right here, because he got 92 speed, guys, with 99 pursuit, 96 zone coverage. Yo, this card is insane looking, man. This card looks insane. Coming off the edge and everything, Miles Jack is going to be nice. You got Leonard Williams as well, a 98. Oh, he actually doesn't have a 99 stat, but he has two 98 stats right there with finesse moves and pursuit. Then, of course, Lane Johnson. He does not have a 99 stat. He actually has a 98 stat right there. And then lastly, Minka Fitzpatrick, I believe, does have a 99, and that is the zone coverage. And he also has 98 play recognition. So really, really nice cards. Let's go and jump into the Madden Trail and get into and see what it's all about. So here is the board. I know I messed up for not playing today, but I wanted to get my first, reactions to it on camera and everything. But I believe the Madden Trail event. Oh, okay. So yesterday, I believe they said that it was going to be somewhat like All Rookie, where the board resets every day at 10:30 a.m. and 7 p.m. Eastern time. So I guess that was something to change. Maybe I got my info wrong right there. But of course, it looks like it's a one-time thing. So it is okay. So one-time thing. So these events though do cost 40 stamina to play though, guys. So you guys got four different types of events, and you guys can see we got the helmet. We got, of course, the cleats, we got the gloves, and then lastly we got the footballs. Now you guys can see the blitz event down here, they're all locked. First reward, okay, so they're all locked. I think you have to clear the whole board to unlock these ones. These ones were actually supposed to be on a timer as well. So yeah, things are changing. Of course, like I said yesterday, sneak peeks, some things are something to change, and that looks like it is a big subject to change, because we thought they were going to be on a rotation there. I believe those ones are still blitz events, so those will be repeatable. But of course, a big thing to point out, guys, achievements wise if we go all the way down to, no, not All Rookie, okay, why do we have to claim them now? That's a little whack. I will claim that afterwards. But you guys can see, if you guys go ahead and finish this for, of course, 5 days straight, they actually lowered it as well. Yesterday it was showing a 94 to 96 overall, so now you're only going to be getting a 92 to 94 overall player. So that kind of sucks, because you do need 96 or 95 pluses for your grandmasters. So that's a little unfortunate that did go ahead and change. But of course, things are subject to change always with a sneak peek and everything. Let's go on and jump into our first live event. So this one is 40 stamina, guys. Every live event is 40 stamina. Play one to unlock the next one. But of course, in this one, we will get 7 Madden intro helmets, 381 overall X Factor players. I believe it caps out at 86, unfortunately. And then, of course, 50 training points. But we'll see. Maybe you guys can pull diamonds. Maybe I'm wrong. If you can pull diamonds, that'd be awesome. That's what I would like to hear. But let's get into it, all right? So here we go, guys. We just got to go ahead and rush for 80 yards. Should be a simple pickup right here. So here we go, running down the middle. Yeah, look at that big block by Jeremy Shockey. Look at that juke move. We can't catch me. Oh, making a man miss. All right, we're going to get that easy touchdown. All right. So, oh, what? They put us at the 75-yard line? Come on now. Come on now. I'm just going to give myself up. What is that? I went and got a touchdown. You made me come all the way back to the hike the ball again. All right. So there we go, guys. Like we said, we know we are going to get 7 football helmets, though, at least. You get 7 of those, I believe. Or wait. Yeah, I think it was, right? 7 football helmets. We got a kick returner with Agnew right there. And, of course, we got the punter and Randy Gregory right there. All right. So there we go. So that is our first event. And once we unlock that one, it's pretty simple. The next one will be up. And then, yeah. So every time you play these events, you will get 7 collectibles each, and also it is ramped up at 381 overall players instead of it just paying out one player. But it looks like there will be no refresh, so once you kind of finish the board, you're kind of done for the day. It's been interesting that they're doing that with programs and stuff like that. Ooh, what a one-handed grab. I forgot to change back to the Patriots. I know we were rocking with the Baltimore Ravens, but of course we did pull that Drew Brees. If you guys haven't checked out that video, go ahead and check it out. We got some gameplay and everything like that. So that was pretty awesome. So yeah, there we go. We finished off the gloved, I think this one was. Or was this one the cleats? This one was the cleats. And you guys see we got 83 overall. So you guys tell me, have you guys got lucky? You guys tell me in the comment section below. You also get 500 coins. Like, I love how they give you coins. Like, they're like, oh yeah, you'll get 500 coins, but then nothing's auctionable, and they're really making coins useless now. But I guess they each their own, all right? But yeah, you guys tell me, can you pull diamonds out of the live events? I really hope you can. That's been always something that's been great inside of other programs and stuff, where you can pull on like those diamonds and everything. Like, oh yes, like I remember playing the New Year's event and you got like a diamond card. Like, yeah, that's all RNG luck, random number generator. Like, it's all up to the odds and everything, but at least have those odds, right? Don't cap me at 86 overall, right? That's what I feel like has just been sucky and everything like that. But there we go. That we just knock them out of the park. Like, even the sets, guys, where you could trade in the 81s to 86s, you could get lucky sometimes before and get yourself a diamond in that set. And now I believe it just caps itself out. So that kind of sucks, but it looks like we're just going to get straight up. So I'll play all of them, at least like all of them to football. And then, of course, we'll check out sets and everything like that. But that's one thing I don't really like. I'll definitely bring that feedback up to the team and be like, yo, why are we being so stingy with the odds now, man, right? Like, before, you could go ahead and do an 81 set, and then you could pull a 90, and then or trade in from an 81s and to like 84, and then you get for the 86 set, if you guys remember what I'm talking about, and then you would be, you have that chance. Like, yeah, the odds may be low, right? Even if the odds are 2% to get a diamond out of that 81 trade-in, that's 2% more than what we have right now, right? Because it caps. And that's what it's been like for the other programs. I'll check the sets before. I don't know if I run my mouth too much right now, but that's how I feel, because I believe it's been like that for the past couple events and everything like that. You guys know they've been capping out, which does suck. As yeah, we still don't pull anything crazy there. So let's go and check out sets, guys. So yesterday we got to see them. It requires 30 items, but let's go ahead and trade this in. So let's see this. So 81s to and 4 other collectibles, and it's going to give you an 86 plus. Okay, so I take it back. Maybe you can pull a diamond. I remember there was one set. Was it under X Factor where you do the trade in and it just requires you an 86 plus? No. Okay, so maybe I'm wrong. I remember there was one set where it like caps you out. And I was just like, wow, that kind of sucks. But all right, I guess they changed it back, so I cannot complain no more. I'm happy with that. I'm happy with that right there. But yeah, so let's go and check out the Masters. So it is requiring you 30 items, guys. What we did do the math kind of yesterday, which was kind of expensive, unless they changed the set. No, they did not. So The sets do require you. So like we said, I'm going to go for Miles Jack. So let's go and do Miles Jack set. So here he is. So he's going to require gloves and trail football. So the nice thing is that you only need 10 and 10 and they give you 7 for the first win. And we have a whole week, right? So there is that. But, and you guys see, okay, so this one's a little better. Miles Jack's better than Dak Prescott because you guys can see. Oh, actually, no, they're all the same. They're all the same, right? They're all the same requirements. They should be all the same. Yeah, yeah. All right, so I'm all over the place today. I'm tired. I just came home from work. Of course, guys, you need 92 overalls. You need 7 of those. And then you also need 3 95 overall players, right? So that is kind of a lot of players-wise, right? Now, how do you guys get the 95s and 92 overalls? We know they're non-auctionable, so you cannot pick them on the auction block. So that means you have to do them inside the sets here. So to get a 92 overall player, how many 92s do you get here? And you only get one. Wow. So you have to put in a 91 overall. You have to put in a 96 overall, and you have to put in 5 of each collectible for 192. Now we know we need 7 of the 92s and then 3 95s. I believe it was yesterday. It was only 2 they were asking for. So the value just went up another for another 2 players, right? So that is kind of crazy because, yo, we need 3 95 pluses, right? It doesn't matter. There's no requirement. Like last time you needed Tua, or I can't remember the other ones, like Tua, Cole Kmet, Brandon Ayuk was one of them. I know the offensive ones because I kind of just, they're ingrained in my head. But yeah, you know, you needed those 3 for specifically. This time around, don't need specific players, but we still need 3 95s and 7 92s, right? So 7 92s are on the board. We automatically know we need 7 92s. Now, in order to get a 95, you need 2 92 overalls. So we need a total of 6 more 92 overall players. So that's a lot. So 6 plus 7, quick math, that's 13. So in total, you will need to go ahead and get 13 92 overall players just to get the Grandmasters. And in order to get the 92 overalls, you have to go ahead and get the players and collectibles. So a lot of requirements, guys. Yes. But I do like the payouts having being 7 of each. And everything like that. And don't forget, you will have, I know it's not a 95 or 96 no more, but of course at the end of 5 days, guys, you guys know that under achievements, we go to Madden Trail, you guys will see that you will get 192 to 94 overall just for completing the board. So make sure you guys are completing the board every single day. And then of course you have your other showdown packs and all that stuff. So yeah. And then of course, guys, you guys will probably see a pack opening tomorrow on the side account and all that stuff. So there are those things. We'll get some masters. We'll get some gameplay and everything like that. But yeah, that is Madden Trail, guys. You guys tell me your thoughts about it. Are you liking it? Honestly, I do like the payouts having 7. I hope that's a lot. Of course, this is the first day. This is my first time looking at the program. But I'm really happy to go ahead and try to hunt for Miles Jack, no money spent and everything like that. I really hope you can get a master, no money spent and all that stuff. But thank you guys so much for watching. You guys know to tune in to for everything Madden Mobile, and that's right here on the channel. Always stay hype, guys, and I'll catch you guys soon. Peace. What's up?